Hello and welcome to OAU iLab. I'll be demonstrating how to perform the Quanser experiment, that's a control engineering experiment. In particular, I'll be dealing with the transient response experiment. Okay, so once you've gotten to this site, you can access at iLab.oau.com/sd. Or if you see your 173.43.93/sd. Once you've navigated to this page, then you can log in with your username and password. As a member of the control engineering group, these are the options you can have, these are the experiments you can perform. Now I'll be selecting the first one, which is the transient response analysis. Okay, now at this stage, you are required to schedule a session or within a session if you've already scheduled one previously. So I'll click on the button to schedule a session. You select the date on which one to perform the experiment. Obviously, you cannot perform it. You cannot perform the experiment on any date prior to this date, but you can select the date or any date after today. So let's say June 14th to today's date, and you can now select whatever time you want to select. So let's select on perform the experiment. The red region is time which has already passed. The green region is here is time during which you can make the selection. The green region is a region which has been selected by another user. Or it's a little bit new, but any region that has already been scheduled, yeah, is gray, right? So you cannot make a selection within that region. So I'll make a selection for the nearest available time, which is about anytime from day 36. The duration of the experiment, I'll select 5 minutes. You can select longer, but I'll just select 5 minutes. I'll make a reservation. Now you could make more than one reservation if you need more than one amount. You need more than just one session to perform the experiment, you can use more than one reservation. But this for me, hopefully, to be satisfactory for this video. So I'll close. And now we have the list of reservations which I have made. In this case, I've made only one reservation from 836 to 845. Okay, so I'll click on that and now scroll down and click on resume reservation. Now we have the launch lab button. So once I click this button, I can now perform the experiment. So I click on launch lab. Now this may take a few minutes or a few seconds depending on network connectivity and some other factors which I'm not going to as the remote end. In a few moments, hopefully, the lab client will load into this browser window. Now, one comment that you make at this point is, I am doing this in Internet Explorer. I'm using Internet Explorer version 9, but you can use anywhere from Internet Explorer version 6, or you can use any of the other popular web browsers. And you tried out this experiment in Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Opera, and Apple Safari, and work fine in each one of these browsers. So you can make use of any of these popular browsers to perform your experiment. So as I mentioned a little earlier, it may take a few seconds to a few minutes, and here it seems to be running up to a minute thereabouts. The reason why it takes this long is that at the remote end, it will first of all need to launch the lab API, which can be a complete experiment. So at the remote end, it will launch the lab API. After launching the lab API at the remote end, then it will now grant one access at the end, and it will embed the API in the web browser. So we're still waiting, and it will come up in a moment. Okay, so it has come up now. So it tells me what time the reservation starts, what time the reservation will end, and then I can just click on OK. Once I click on OK, then it will now download the lab API into this region here. Let's go down a little bit so we can see the image of the projection. Okay, so here's our lab API. I'm embedded it in the web browser window, and now I can control the motor at the remote end. Now remember, this is the transient response analysis. So we're interested in the transient response, that's how they send the response to our input. So first of all, I'll run this lab API. Now the lab API is running. Now even though the lab API is running, we are not yet controlling the motor. they will tell it to start, they will click on this button which says start control of the motor. We are not yet running the motor, but in the meantime, we are suspending certain voltage. Now this is voltage which we will send in. Alright, this is the expected speed. The expected speed of the motor. That's just doing my normal calculation. This is voltage we are sending into the motor. In this case, it's 2 volts. How do I know that? Let's say I wanted to send a 1.5 volt instead of 2 volts, and let's say I wanted to send a 0.3 hertz. So let's say we have that, then I can say start control of the motor. When I start control of the motor, it will now apply this voltage and this frequency. This signal we are sending is applied to the motor. Now click on start control, and then you see the red will no longer be 0 radians per second, but the right to whatever value actually is. I click on start control, and now we see the actual speed of the motion. Now the expected speed is the blue, and the red is what we are actually getting. So you see that there is some steady state error, and the steady state error seems to be larger in the negative half than in the positive half. In the positive half, it's probably something like 5 radians per second. Negative half, it's probably up to 25 or 20 radians per second. But that's the negative half. Now remember, we're interested in the transient response. So you're interested in things like rise time and setting time. So if I pause the plot at this point, you see the time it takes the speed of the motor to rise to its new resting point. So you can look at this as the step response of your motor. So if you get the step response of your motor, and based on that, get the time constant of this motor. And if you can get the time constant of the motor, then you can calculate what the transfer function of this motor is supposed to be. And we start with this way. Now, in this case, we're using a square wave. You could have decided to use a triangular wave instead. And to use a triangular wave, now we try to see how the motor is supposed to respond to the voltage. Now I'd like you to see something. Let me reduce the frequency a little more. I don't know if you notice something. What happens at the zero crossing? Now you'll be interested in finding out what does that mean. Why does the speed of the motor drop to zero for a period and then go negative? Why does that happen? I'll refuse to answer that in this video, but you can answer that, and I think the answer is rather obvious. So that's how to perform the experiment. I'll go back to the square wave. I'll stop the control of the motor. Now to stop this program, you scroll down to this button which says exit. So I'll click on exit and it stops the VI. Okay, so that stops the VI. I'll just fill up the display to see. Okay, so our run button is back here. Now I'll just do something which is, I'll click on edit and I'll say the initialize value to default. The reason why I'm doing that is so that the next person who comes to perform this experiment will have the default value, which was 2 for amplitude and 0.4 for frequency. So now I'm done with my experiment. The assumption is affecting my reading while I was performing all this experiment. I've done whatever observations I want to do. So I can now go back to the interactive settings broker. I could decide to log out, or I could decide to perform any other thing I wanted to do. For instance, I could want to perform that experiment. Now, if you want, now, in order to schedule 5 minutes, I could just click on this and check. My 5 minutes are not yet off. So if I wanted to perform a different experiment at this time, I can decide to remove this reservation. Remove it so that the current time is now available once again. So it is usually in practice, you do not need a reservation to remove that reservation so that somebody else or yourself can perform an experiment using that time. So once you have scheduled an experiment for a certain time, whether or not you are using the lab, nobody will be able to perform an experiment apart from you doing that time. So click on my experiment, it just shows you a list of experiments which you have performed before. Now this experiment I just performed. And the only experiment that performed is that. So just tell you the details of the experiment to perform. At completion time, experiment not clear. The reason why it's saying that is because the time did not lapse after the time. I finished the experiment before the time lapsed. And that's why it says experiment not clear. So that's my problem. Okay? So once you download everything, you can load out to prepare your report and submit to your lecturer and to the lecturer. Now this video can be found in the description of this video.